Stay Black in America, greatest country in the world. Sermon number 129th in a row for me. Thank God for that. I'm going to title this Divine Timing. Divine Timing. As we are born and we go through our lives, we encounter certain things. Being a child, going through puberty, becoming a man or becoming a woman. And in between that thing, everybody has different facets, different things that encounter, different things that come in your life through timing and chance. Timing and chance. Some people have horrible experiences in homes. Some people have broken up homes. Father's not there, mother's not there. No safety net. In a system, maybe. Foster homes, other type things, blended homes, grandparents maybe raising children, their parents couldn't, drugs come into there, people on drugs, people on alcohol, all kind of things that affect the human life, the human condition. But we have divine timing by God. When is this divine timing come in your life? Do you happen to meet someone who's a child of God and says, you know, God can change, it's not going to change your past, but can sure change your present and your future. Are you going to listen to that voice, or are you going to say, well, no, I know it all. I'm going to continue to follow my path. Well, that time and chance might have came for you. You might have let it come and go by because maybe you felt like some atheists, or most atheists, or all atheists. I don't believe in God. I just believe in evolution. We're just a step above the chimpanzees, and if you study them, they kill each other, they have wars against each other, they love meat. Matter of fact, they treat humans just like prey. Eat human babies in Uganda and other places of Africa where a lot of their trees and stuff have been cut down so humans can plant and cultivate, and so their food chain is narrowing down, so humans are a food source for chimpanzees, like they're a food source for lions and hyenas and everything else, right? A food source. But divine timing. What's with divine timing? Divine timing is God's timing for you. God has spoke to man from time to time throughout the years. Spoke to man and led man away. Gave man free will to do whatever he wants to do. Does that man want to ask God what you wanted me, God? Or that man want to live out his own dreams, do his own thing, search out his own happiness? Divine timing. So the Lord gives us this precious holy Bible. We can read through thousands of years of God's intervention with men concerning timing. We can look at very familiar to a lot of people who preachers who do funerals and such of that to try to make the families feel a little better, or just words to fill in the emptiness. And they say, starts off in Ecclesiastes, was just the third chapter, the first verse on to the ninth verse, when it speaks about there is an appointed time for everything, and there is a time for everything under the sun. They say it's a time to give birth, a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw stones and a time to gather stones, a time to embrace and a time to shun embracing, a time to search and a time to give up as lost, a time to throw away and a time to tear apart and a time to sew together, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. Gives you all kind of times under the sun that things occur, but divine timing. When you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior and repent of your sins, divine timing has come to you in the most precious way. God sent his beloved son to die for the sins of all mankind, those who came before and those who came after. the answer for them all. Because we cannot save ourselves. Our sins will take us right to hell in a handbasket. So God had to send his perfect son to die, to take our sins upon himself and to die. So we have a free gift of heaven through grace. You accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and repent of your sins, you're going to heaven by grace, not by works. Come as you are, whatever circumstance you're in, whatever weakness you have, whatever vice, whatever thing you have is doing wrong, whatever thing that makes you feel unworthy, you come to Christ in prayer. You repent of your sins, you ask for forgiveness, and Christ comes and dwells within inside of you and starts working the inner man. Because your soul, your body is just a covering for your soul. So divine timing can work for you in a lot of ways. If you read Mark 1st chapter 15 verse, it says, repent and believe. Repent and believe. Repent and believe and you become saved. Saved by grace. Because God wants everybody to come to heaven. Nobody wants anybody to go to hell. But believe me, we have a righteous God. If you don't accept his son as your Lord and Savior and repent of your sins, hell is waiting for you. The wrath of God is all over you. You're going straight to hell. And that's an eternal death forever. We have our chances now as humans to bypass that. Whatever circumstance we find ourselves in, whatever sins we have committed, whatever things we think wrong in our mind, you have an opportunity to bypass that by grace. Whether you're strong, whether you're mighty, whether you're poor, whether you're weak, whether you're blind, whether you're deaf, that message is going to come to you one way or another. You have a choice to decide for yourself, to accept it or to deny it. One is heaven, one is hell. When we pass away, it's no rest in peace. Your body, which was a covering for your soul, is dead, deteriorating. Your soul, which was covered by your body, is immortal. Lives forever, either in heaven with God the Father or in hell with your father the devil, one way or another. And so we go on and look at Psalms 31st chapter 15th verse. Deliver me from the hands of my enemy. We pray and ask God deliver us from the hands of an enemy, people who hate you for no reason, people who want to see bad come to you. You pray to God. You pray to your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. If we look at Romans 8:28, it says, all things work together for good for those who what are called according to his purpose. You accept Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior, and repent of your sins. All things are going to work together for good for you one way or another. It's going to work for good. Your faith, your endurance, your continued praying, your continued prayer. Everything is going to work together for your good. Let's take it. Jeremiah 29:11. It says, I know the thoughts that I have towards you, saith the Lord. His thoughts towards you are peace and in the future, and prosperity, protection from evil. This is what our God has for you. Our God is full of love, full of mercy, full of kindness. But the wrath of God will fall upon you. Right now, you're living. You have your living existence. You're going to be touched by God and God's word the course of your life. God might be leading you sometimes in the right way because maybe somebody in your family has prayed for you. Maybe prayed for you before you was born. And God is trying to maneuver you to come to him. But it's your will. And that devil, he's going to work against you. Every time, he's going to work against you. The spiritual things all around us. We can only see certain things with our natural eyes that exist around us every day. But with spiritual eyes, you can see much more than you ever imagined. Ever imagined. So, divine timing. Divine precious timing, man, is what you want. Because it's God's timing. It's God's timing and it's divine. He's going to bring things to you the right time. When you're able to consume them properly, when you're able to mentally be able to digest it, he's going to bring it to you the right time. We want to rush our way through things. We want to rush to get old. He used to say you want to get young and old. You see something fake. You want to rush to get old. You don't want to live your time. But enjoy every stage of your life. Young people, enjoy every stage of life. You like cartoons, you like laughing and playing, running, doing things. Enjoy that young part. Don't try to skip over the part to adulthood. You're not ready for it. You don't need to be a teenager having babies. You don't need to be a little kid smoking cigarettes or drugs. You don't need to be involved in those things, whether you're a little kid or teenager, an adolescent to a young adult to an adult. Some things you need to avoid altogether. Avoid some things and be fruitful. Get caught up in some things, and what are you like? You're like a fish, you know, in the ocean, and somebody casts a line, and you just going about your life, and phew, caught up in that fish line, food for somebody. Bird flying around free, and you caught in some snare. Didn't know it was there, and you're done. So many things can fall upon you in this life. I've seen many young men who died before their times, shot and killed in the street, maybe involved in crimes, maybe involved in accidents, maybe involved in a lot of things, where the life is like snuffed away before you even think they start to live. Or you see them mature, and then it's snuffed away. But through that time from born to death, in between there, they had some time when they were exposed to God in some kind of way, exposed to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, either accepted it or rejected it. Some voice they listened to, there was a negative voice. And we got a lot of negative voices out here. We got voices speaking all kind of perverse things, all kind of abominations, and some things that people gravitate to, because human nature tends to want to gravitate toward the evil and not toward the good, right? But you got to dig deep within yourself. You want to change your circumstances or your situation, you got to put your trust in your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You got to work, because work, faith without works is dead. You got to put effort into it. God's not going to be a magical thing that happened to you. You're going to have to apply yourself in this world we live in to be successful at anything. You put your hand in it, your might in it, you're working, you let it consume you, and you succeed, you rise up. But trust in your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, because he's going to bring everything to you in the right time. You know, there's a time when educated, when you go to, you know, these K-1 and K-2, and you're in elementary school, the junior high, the high school, the college, the grad school, or whatever it's going to be. It's all a continual graduation. Some people, yeah, skip it. It's all going to be places where people are going to skip it, and they're going to jump in, they're going to jump in because of a higher intelligence or ability to maintain knowledge quicker. But all our ultimate victory is our victory in Jesus Christ. When Jesus Christ made the victory over sin, destroyed sin, crucified, rose on the third day, all divine timing. It was pre-told by God that Jesus knew he had to do, and Jesus was telling his disciples the same he had to do, but it was so horrific that a lot of them were caught off guard, even though they were told what was going to happen, still caught off guard. Almost like somebody training for a fight and thinking they know everything, and all of a sudden something happens that throws them off guard, something they didn't expect, something they didn't predict that fighter might have knew how to do, and then they had thrown off guard. So divine timing, our prayers, our worship to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ helps protect us from these things that may occur out of the blue. See, because we pray, Lord God, lead and guide my steps. Protect me from evil. Protect me from evil seen and unseen. Protect my family. Protect all of us from those kind of things. You pray for protection so these things don't happen. So you're not amongst the people that say, how in the world could there be a God if a drunk driver killed a kid walking across the street? You're going to blame God for the free will gift he's giving you so that drunk driver could consume more alcohol than he humanly needs, so he was incoherent and couldn't know what he's doing, and some kid walking across the street minding the business made you want to look in both ways and gets hit. Don't blame God for that. That's free will. Free will. So that means that you would pray for that child, that God protect and watch over that child. Something might have protected and watched. You might have saw something, heard something, moved out of the way. Maybe avoid it. Like sometimes your life, you say, oh, wait, I missed the accident by just 5 minutes. I missed something that would have happened. I missed a bridge collapsing. I missed a bomb blowing over there. I missed something happened, some hurricane. I missed something by just the skin of my chinny chin chin, right? So divine timing, man, pray for it. Pray that God puts you in the right timing and chance, because there was once a man who stored up all his bonds and with grain and food and thought he could sit back and take it easy now because he had done all his works. And the Bible says he didn't know his life was required of him that next day. Died and passed away with all his storage and foods and grains that went to somebody else. Timing and chance, right? So we want to pursue. We want to live out our best person, do as best we can. We're very smart. We're very intelligent. We want to utilize all our abilities to the best we can. But in all the utilizing of the abilities and the best we can, remember the divine timing outweighs them all. All of us will succumb to death one time or another. Some twice, right? You know? we die in a human form, and then when we go to hell, we die in a spiritual form, even though the spirit is still alive. It's like an eternal death, right? Eternal death with pain. So, again, accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior and repent of your sins. This is your opportunity to gain the kingdom. You come as you are. You don't think that some sin that is so important for you to keep doing that you don't accept Christ. Christ is the thing that separates you from hell. When you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior and repent of your sins, your timing is perfect. The angels rejoice in heaven by everybody which comes to the kingdom. Your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. So, divine timing, man. Timing and chance. Who knows? Who knows what's going to occur under the sun the next day? Who knows what might befall upon man? Maybe another pandemic. Maybe a war. Maybe famine. Maybe shortage of this, shortage of that. But if you keep your hands in the Lord's hands, keep trusting in God, trusting in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, God's going to provide a way of escape for you. He's going to provide a way that you are not in need, but you have an abundance. Have an abundance. So put your faith, put your hope, put your prayers in God, your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and divine timing will be on your side every time. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Stay Black in America. Till next time.